Back when we talked about how we could add groups to double bonds, we discussed how there were three different ways to add water to a double bond to make an alcohol. Well, it turns out that if we add water to a triple bond, we still are going to get that alcohol. The thing is that we're going to get a slightly different product. Instead of just having a single bond with an alcohol, we're now going to have a double bond with an alcohol attached to it. And even though that sounds like a very minor difference, that's actually going to translate into a huge difference in the functional group that we get afterwards, all right? So let's go into this right now. This is going to be the hydration of triple bonds. So it turns out that anytime that you make a vinyl alcohol, that's the name of basically having an alcohol directly on a double bond, that is going to react very uniquely. It's not going to react like the addition reactions that we saw with double bonds. In fact, this is going to do a phenomenon called tautomerization. Now, this is a phenomenon that we're not going to fully understand the mechanism for until Orgo 2. So it's kind of, you know, unfortunate that we have to talk about it now, but I'm just going to give you guys like a really quick fresh refresher on what this is so that you guys know what tautomerization is. So basically, if I were to summarize it, I'm not going to teach you the full mechanism because that would be a whole separate lesson, but all you really need to know is that they're going to reversibly swap the position of a hydrogen, okay, and a pi bond, okay? So this is what I'm saying. Anytime that you make a vinyl alcohol, this is something special. This is not a regular alcohol. This is an alcohol that is now subject to a phenomenon called tautomerization. So here I'll show you. Here would be an alcohol that's directly attached to a double bond. This is vinyl alcohol. And through the tautomerization process that I'm not going to show you the mechanism for, this is going to turn into a completely different functional group where basically my double bond is going to move over here. My H is going to move down here. So these are going to switch places. And what's going to wind up happening is that you get a carbonyl formed, and instead of this being a CH2, now this is going to turn into a CH3. So what winds up happening is that this turns from a vinyl alcohol to a ketone, all right? How did that happen? Like I said, unfortunately, it would take me 20 minutes to explain this whole thing to you. So instead, I'm just going to tell you guys to memorize that a double bond and a hydrogen switch places anytime that you have a vinyl alcohol, all right? Now, we do have some fancy words for this because this is its own thing. Basically, when it's in the vinyl alcohol phase, that's called the enol, all right? And that makes sense because ene stands for alkene, al stands for alcohol. So it's basically whenever you have an alcohol on the alkene, that would be called an enol. Well, the enol rapidly tautomerizes to the keto form. The keto form is just the ketone or the aldehyde that's produced after tautomerization takes place. Now, what you notice is that I didn't draw these equilibrium arrows evenly. This is a phenomenon that's constantly in equilibrium, but one of the arrows is much bigger than the other. And that's because it turns out that the keto form is going to be favored in almost all cases, highly favored over the enol form. So what that means is that immediately upon making any vinyl alcohol, or most vinyl alcohols, I can expect it to rapidly transform into the keto phase. And the keto side of the equilibrium looks like a ketone or an aldehyde. So in basically, the whole gist of what I'm trying to say is that anytime that you hydrate a triple bond, you're actually going to get a ketone or an aldehyde as the product, all right? And it's through this process of tautomerization. Now, exactly which ones do we get? Let's go ahead and look at each specific reagent.